Welcome to the interview series by Utkarshini EdTech. Today we have Sheetal with us. We may start with your introduction, Sheetal.
Hey all, I'm Sheetal Prakash, currently doing my final year in computer science engineering, and I'm currently placed at Dover Corporation.
Okay, coming to your profile, where are you placed right now and what is your job profile?
So I've been placed at Dover Corporation. And the current job profile is a software engineer. And upon talking with the HR and the team, I got to know it's something to do with the cloud stack.
That's great. Moving forward to the placement procedure, what was the overall structure of the placement process?
So first we had, it was through campus placements. So it was through the registration on First Naukri. And then later we had the online test. So the online test was followed by 3 rounds of interview and then a final release of the shortlisted students.
How was the coding round and where did you prepare for that?
Okay, so as I said, the first round, which was the coding round, it had two parts, which was the technical aptitude and the coding round. So the technical aptitude mainly focused a lot on the programming part, along with a little bit of DBMS and MySQL as well, which was the database part, not much on the OS side. And then coding round, we had two questions and together put together, we had to complete it in 20 minutes. So because of the time constraint, yes, it was a easy question, I would say. I could pass all the test cases, and post which we had the interview. So coming to preparation for the coding round, I mainly focused on Geeks for Geeks, and then later I moved on to LeetCode as well.
Okay, so what was the interview like? How many rounds did you have and what did you feel the toughest to crack?
Okay, so we had 3 rounds of interview. The first one was technical, the second with the hiring manager, and the third was the HR. And I think, to be honest, the most difficult one to crack was the HR interview. Because, you know, the HR round, you can never say about what they're going to ask you and from where it's going to come. Like, because you just can't prepare anything in specific for a HR round. So the first one, technical round, they focused a lot on the basic concepts of object-oriented programming. They had given me code snippets, and then they gave a lot of test cases and asked me to, you know, predict the output or what would be, and discussed it at length about why and what it would be. And it mainly focused a little bit on the inheritance, polymorphism kind of concepts. And next, I had to run them. They gave me a problem statement, and I had to run them through the pseudocode and what would be my approach to solving that question. I didn't have to execute it, but then I had to run them through the process of the problem, how I would deal with the problem statement, and a little bit discussion on further on the programming side, and a little bit on my projects. And next was the hiring manager round. So in that, he focused a lot on, so they had asked me a choice of which subject I would want to be asked on. So I had chosen DBMS and OS. So I got asked a few concepts from DBMS and OS. And after that, we had a little bit discussion on my resume and what are the projects and courses that I've done so far. The final round was the HR. So the HR round, so they gave me puzzles, like around 5 to 6 puzzles to solve. And I think those were the tricky parts because they were simple. It just tested a lot on your analytical and the logical reasoning. So post that, you know, we had like a general discussion on my family background, hobbies, passion, and all that, the general HR questions.
Okay, so how about the group discussion?
We didn't have a group discussion. It was only these 3 rounds.
What is the weightage of the CGPA and the project to make in the placement?
So CGPA, to be honest, I don't think a role because most companies that came, it depended on the companies again. Some came for, you know, had a cutoff of 7, 7.5. I think majority of the companies had a cutoff of an average at 8. There were very few companies which came, which had a cutoff of 8.5. And I have a GPA of 9. So I think... you know, the role that the GPA played was mainly in the cutoff process, but it didn't have any weightage to do with the selection or, you know, with your interviews as such. And coming to the courses, yes, it did play a lot of importance because the projects that I did were like an afterspin of the courses. It was related to the courses that I had done. So, yeah, having many projects and along with proper certifications and courses did add a lot of impression and weightage on the resume, especially when you're dealing with the hiring manager and HR.
Okay, what are the key things you did during your preparation?
Okay, so key things. So one is, I guess I had to balance out between the coding and the technical aptitude along with the logical aptitude, quantitative aptitude. So there are many companies who don't ask for the quantitative aptitude, but yes, they also should not be completely neglected because especially when some finance companies like, you know, JP Morgan, Morgan Stanley, Goldman Sachs, all these companies that come, they test a lot on the quantitative aptitude. In fact, they give more weightage to the equal weightage to quantitative and technical capabilities. So I think balancing out on the coding and your quantitative aptitude, depending on where you stand at, I think you should be able to divide your time accordingly. So that was one thing that I focused on. And yeah.
Okay. Which myths and facts turned out to be true after placement?
Okay, so this might sound trivial, but then I guess luck plays a really important factor in determining which company and where and what CTC you land up with. Because I've seen my own friends, you know, like it's not true that the person with the highest CTC is the best coder or is the smartest of the lot. So I think a lot of key factors play you know, you finally land up. It's not purely your technical or your quantitative capabilities. It's a lot of like the timing in which the company comes or the, because, you know, it also affects who your competitors are in finally, which will, you know, get you to where you are. So a lot of like timing, your luck, and sometimes, you know, the interviewer also matters a lot because some people, they got a really strict interviewer who was very particular and drilled them, and some people had it easy. So that again, it was a pure matter of luck and games. So I think when they say, you know, a person with the highest CTC is not the smartest, or the person with the lowest CTC is not like the least capable person. So it all matters on your luck as well.
Yes. So if you can contact your past self who is about to start the placement preparation, what would you say to her?
Okay. Start early. Like, and this is one thing that I really wish I had done, because for the first few companies that came, like, I was totally off guard. Like, I hadn't started like a preparation in full swing, and it was like, you know, on and off preparation. So the first few companies that came, I just gave it out of, you know, in an unprepared state. So which was something that, you know, and the first few companies that came were really good ones as well. So yeah, I still regret that, you know, probably if I had prepared better, then maybe I could have cracked it.
Okay, that's bring us to the end. Any other suggestions and remarks for you juniors?
So suggestions, I think, you know, technical capabilities, like, you can come on, there's like a lot of sources out there, you can do it. But I think staying emotionally and mentally fit and stable during the entire placement process is also very important. And, you know, especially when you see your own peers, your own friends, your own benchmates getting placed, and, you know, probably you aren't getting. So that will like really shatter you a lot and test a lot of your emotional stability as well. So I think, you know, just staying strong throughout, no matter whether you make it in or not, or when you make it in, I think that staying strong throughout, like mentally also should be something taken care of, because it's a really excruciating process. You know, one, you have like companies coming one after the other, and then you end up seeing the emails where your name is not there and people who you know are there on the list. So yeah, stay strong, and yeah, things will turn out good. There are thousands of opportunities out there, so something or the other will click if it is meant for you, then it's meant for you, I guess.
Yes, definitely. So thank you for joining us and sharing your experience, Sheetha.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. I'm